All right, Shalom, Israel, Most High in Christ, bless. Welcome to another episode of 15 Minutes with the Captains. My name is Captain Palu, and to my right,
Officer Enos.
So today, we're going to go over real quick. We don't have a lot of time, but real quick. I'm going to go over the curses, which identify who the nation of Israel are. Sometimes, this will be a very good video for those that's coming in, want to know who they are, and trying to identify who they are. What's the nationality? So I'm going to go through a couple of scriptures in the Deuteronomy chapter 28 and try to explain them and so you can get the understanding. All right? Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Come on.
But it shall come to pass.
It said what?
It shall come to pass.
It said it shall come to pass, meaning it's going to happen. It's going to happen. The curses that Moses is about to read to the nation of Israel, it's going to happen. Come on.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So if we don't listen to God, come on.
To observe to do all his commandments.
Come on.
And his statutes.
And his statutes, come on.
Which I command thee this day.
God is commanding us right here to keep the commandments of God. But guess what? Our people hate doing what God tell them to do. That's a problem. We hate doing what God tell us. And that's why we in the demise we in today. That's why we've been on 400 years of slavery. Because we want to disobey God. It's time to stop that foolishness. All right? Come on.
That all these curses shall come upon thee.
That all what?
That all these curses shall come upon thee.
He said all of these curses that I'm about to tell the nation of Israel, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. It's not an if. It's not
a maybe.
It shall. It's going to happen. Come on.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
And it's going to consume our people. And this was talking prophetic to us. The people you see today, our people right now. All right? This is talking about us. All right? Come on. Let me go. We're going to get some scriptures to prove that this is talking about us. But first, get Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 45 first.
This is the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 45.
Come on.
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee.
So it's the same thing that he was talking about in verse 15. Come on.
Till thou be destroyed.
Till we be destroyed. Till we are completely destroyed, meaning our mindset, we lose who we are. You know, because right now when we ask, who are you? What's your nationality? We say Christian. Mm-hmm. We say black, African-American. We don't have any idea who we are today. We've been dumbed down. We've been destroyed mentally by our oppressors that the Most High God sent to be over us. Because why? We broke God's commandments. Come on.
And overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
Until we be destroyed. Come on.
Because thou hearkenest not.
Because we hate doing what God said, like I said before. We don't want to listen. Come on.
Unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Come on.
To keep his commandments.
To keep his commandments. We don't want to listen. We don't want to hearken to keep God's commandments. His commandments aren't grievous. This is what's going to help our people. This is what's going to help our community. If we keep the commandments of God. All right? Come on.
To keep his commandments and his statutes, which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
It said, and they, those curses that's going to come upon the nation of Israel, is going to be a sign to identify who they are today. Come on.
For a sign and for a wonder.
And for a wonder. For a sign which identifies and for a wonder. You just... Sometimes when you see things happening to you, you be like, dang, why is this happening to our people? Why are we getting shot dead by these police officers and they getting away? You all right? You know what I'm saying? Why are all our black women coming up missing?
Right.
Our black babies coming up missing? Hmm. Why is that happening? Come on.
Upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
And for a wonder. And another wonder. Why are we shooting each other? Why are we killing each other dead? Why are we selling drugs to one another? These other nations don't do that.
Right.
But why are we doing it? Come on.
And upon thy seed forever.
So this is going to be upon our seed. This is going to identify us forever. So we must find out, okay, so how do we identify who we are? the curses that came upon the nation of Israel. And we're going to go through that. Give me verse 16.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 16.
Come on.
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
It said, cursed shalt thou be in the cities. Come on.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Because in the field we was what? In slavery. We was picking cotton. We was doing all those things. Ain't no different from today, us being in the city working for Esau today. We slaving, working on the Sabbath. You know what I'm saying? We working on the Sabbath. We busting our behind, pulling doubles and all of this to make pennies for Esau.
Right.
All right? We're going through the same things. We cursed in the cities. They disrespect us the same way as they did back then. It's no different. Come on.
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Uh-huh.
Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store.
It said, cursed shall be thy basket and thy store. The businesses that we accumulate and that we bring to the table, they don't prosper. Because we got to keep the commandments. We got to do what God says in order for us to prosper. If you read Joshua chapter 1, verse 8 and 9, that's how we prosper. That's how we move forward. But the people today, they're not keeping no commandments. That's why they destroyed the Most High allowed Black Wall Street to be destroyed. Yeah, it was a beautiful thing. Them coming up, our people coming together, having our own dollar. It took a year for the dollar to go out to circulate out of the town. We did a major thing. But guess what? It got destroyed. Why? Because we was missing something. The commandments of God. That's what we was missing. And we've done that numerous times in other states where we built communities.
Right.
We had our own businesses, and they all got destroyed because we lacked the commandments of God. Come on.
Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store.
Now, drop down to verse 21.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 21.
Come on.
The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee.
The pestilence cleave unto thee, right? What happened to the Native Americans? When the Native Americans over here and they came over here and tried to take the land, they gave them what? Smallpox.
Mm-hmm.
All type of different diseases to kill off the Native Americans, the so-called Native Americans, the Gadites, the Reubenites that was over here in the land. Over here in the land of the north, which is America,
mm-hmm.
South America, Central America, they came and they put diseases upon us to kill us off.
Right.
Come on.
The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee.
And the Most High God allowed it to happen to us. Babies died. Women that was pregnant, they mm-hmm. died with the baby. All that happened. Why? Because we disobedient to God.
Right.
Come on.
Until he have consumed thee from off the land,
uh-huh.
whither thou goest to possess it.
Because what happened? They end up taking the land, and we end up building it today.
Right.
They took our land, and we had to build it, and we're still at the bottom of society today.
Right.
Today, we're the only people that have went through this, these curses. No other nations have went through this, and we're going to keep proving it. Come on.
Verse 22.
Start at verse 26 again. Go to verse 26.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 26.
So I'm going to skip around so I can go through different variations of curses, all right? Because it's a lot to read. When you go back and read the whole chapter of 28, from verse 15, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1 down to 14, all the blessings God was going to give us if we kept the commandments of God.
Right.
But notice from 15 to 68 are curses.
Mm-hmm.
So it's much more curses that came upon our people than it would have been blessings if we kept the commandments.
Right.
But we would have had everything. We would have ruled the earth. Come on.
And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air.
So what did they do? They came and gave us smallpox. Oh, they came over and gave us smallpox. They had guns. They had everything. They took everything. They killed over 33 million Native American Indians.
Right.
Over 33 million. Left them out there to die.
Right.
And this is what it's talking about. Read that again.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 26.
Uh-huh.
And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air.
And it said, the carcass shall be meat to all fowls of the air. We didn't get a proper burial when we died.
Right.
They left us to die, and the fowls came and ate us. Mm-hmm. Let's prove that. Give me some, hold that. Give me Psalm 79 and 1. Psalm 79, verse 1.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 79 and verse 1.
Come on.
Oh God, the heathen are come into thine inheritance.
Uh-huh.
Thy holy temple have they defiled.
Come on. Same way they did. They came to our land and took over. Come on.
Thy holy temple have they defiled.
Uh-huh.
They have laid Jerusalem on heaps.
Come on.
The dead bodies of thy servants.
The what?
The dead bodies of thy servants.
The dead body of thy servants. Come on.
Have they given to be meat unto the fowls of the heaven.
Same thing happened. This is what the curses are talking about. That happened then.
Right.
So the curses said, okay, this is what's going to happen. They're going to leave you out for dead, and the fowls of the earth is going to eat you up. And then you read about it later on in mm-hmm. history. It said it shall happen. It's going to happen to our people. We're the only people that went through that.
Right.
No other nations went through that turmoil. Period. That's history. The Bible is our history book. It's our records. For too long, we have sat there and let dust accumulate on our Bibles, on the nightstand, on the coffee table.
Right.
We don't want to pick it up and read it. It's your history. This is how we're going to build our communities back up. This is how we're going to build as a nation again, by keeping the commandments of God and identifying who we are first and foremost. All right, go back to 26.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 26.
Come on.
And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air
uh-huh.
and unto the beasts of the earth, and no man shall fray them away.
And no man shall fray them away. Jump down to verse 30.
Verse 30.
Come on.
Thou shalt betroth the wife, and another man shall lie with her.
Ain't that what happened? We have a lot of movies that come out where we was in slavery. And the slave masters will bring their buddies over.
Mm-hmm.
They can be in Virginia and somebody come from Massachusetts come to visit, hang out, or whatever. And what happened was they would go and pick. Remember, we had wives then too.
Right.
We had wives. But they'll go and pick out somebody's wife, one of our people's wife, and take them into the dang shack and let him rape her, have sex with her,
mm-hmm.
for wine, for music.
Right.
That's what happened to our people. The movies show you exactly what happened in history.
Right.
It said it again. Read that again.
Verse 30. Uh-huh. Thou shalt betroth the wife.
So you're going to betroth the wife. Come on.
And another man shall lie with her.
And another man is going to lay down and have sex with that woman.
Right.
When she's promised to you. Come on.
Thou shalt build an house,
uh-huh.
and thou shalt not dwell therein.
And we built the houses. We built the plantations. Mm-hmm. Same thing today. We've built America off the sweat of our backs. We've done that. The Native Americans, the so-called Native Americans, so-called Hispanics and blacks, we built it. We built America while the other nations are the CEOs of these construction companies or whatever for infrastructures and whatnot. We built America, and we don't enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We don't enjoy none of that. And the scriptures talks about that. Come on.
Thou shalt plant a vineyard and shall not gather the grapes thereof.
And we planted vineyards. We had fruits and vegetables that we planted, and we had to go pick. But guess what? We didn't get none of that.
Right.
But what did we get? Pork. We got all type of rations that now we think are delicates today, and we're supposed to eat these unclean foods
mm-hmm.
that we accumulated and we've inherited over the years that we don't think is something wrong with it.
Right.
We're destroyed in the mind. That's what happened to our people. The Bible is telling us that. Come on.
Verse 31.
Uh-huh.
Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes.
And that's the same thing happened to the Native Americans. Who remembers that photo where it had all the oxen heads, a dang small plateau of oxen heads, and you see Esau, the so-called white man, standing on the top of it? They killed the cattle.
Right.
Why? To starve us out. We use not only the cattle, the oxen, and all that for food, for meat, but we use it for tools, utensils, and all types of things we use it for. For clothing, for covers and stuff like that when it's cold.
Shelter.
We use the whole animals, but they killed them off. Why? Because we'll starve. They did something calculated. That's why in Psalms 83, they made a tumult. The other nations came in one consent and was confederate against the nation of Israel. So we'll never know who we are. But guess what? It's a new day today. The Spirit of the Most High God has woken the nation of Israel up right now. And we're standing before you. All right? So if you have questions, please reach out. Please reach out and understand who you are according to the Bible.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.